Hello everyone, my name is Cristian Negulescu, and you know me for a lot of connectors, for UiPath, connector for Salesforce, ServiceNow, Jira, Confluence, and so on. I did some videos about ServiceNow with the raw comments, yeah? So sending commands to the ServiceNow without any activity. So here it's a simple, it's commands, how to send REST API commands without an activity, and here you have auto authentication, download files, and so on. Yes, but I want to show today some use cases what you can do with UiPath without an activity. How what you can control with ServiceNow. I have in the past a video with use cases here, and here what we'll do, we'll we take from ServiceNow some, for example, you take an incident from with the status, state in progress that are assigned to the hardware group, and we extract this incident and put it on Excel, or we have some incidents on the Excel and then we update the state of the incidents and the description inside of ServiceNow. So today we'll do this without using an activity. So I will show the raw comments. Before we'll start, I will change the resolution of my PC to be able to have a better quality for you to follow, yeah? So I'm back, now we have another, I changed the resolution of the PC. So we are on the incident, and like I said, we want to extract the incident with a state and assign group. So by default, your ServiceNow is not looking like this. So you can go here on the settings of ServiceNow, and you can set exactly what elements you want to see on the screen, yeah? In my case, I will say that I want to use the state and the sign group, yeah? So what I will do, I personalize my output like this. And now I will use the ServiceNow system to search. So I want all the incidents that are in progress, yeah? So I'll write here in progress, and I will write here that are part of hardware. Yeah. Okay. So these are the two incidents that are with state in progress and are part of group hardware. Now, I want to extract this command. So if I want to extract this command, I will go here and I will say copy URL. Yeah. So if I say copy URL, I will get this stuff. Like this, and I will show you immediately what's the idea. And I can say also copy query. I can go here and say copy query, yeah? And this way I will get exactly what ServiceNow did, what ServiceNow interface did for that stuff, yeah? So you can see here on the query that it state into to its the that means that it's in progress. And statement group name start with hardware, yeah? So this is the query that I need to do. Let me explain a little. So for the states here, you can see this on this video that I have here, that they you have different numbers for the states value. If it's one, it's new. If it's two, it's on progress. If it's fine, if it's assigned, if it's six, it's resolved, close, and so on. You'll find this on the internet. Okay. So I have the query created by the ServiceNow instance. And to send a comment, I will send it like this. So I will, this is my instance, and I will put it here, instance name. ServiceNow API table incident, in my case incident, I can use other tables. And this is the query, yeah? So system param query. And from the system param query, I can copy this query. And this will be my comment. Okay, let's see what we'll do in UiPath to get this data. In UiPath Studio, I will go here. I have an HTTP request. This HTTP request, so to be able to have this HTTP request inside of your project, you need first to install web activities from UiPath. Web activities, so this one. UiPath web activities. If you have this one, you will have HTTP request inside of your system. So I'll do an HTTP request. I will do a GET method because it's the system that I get the data. I will put exactly the link that I give you. You see the link from here, from Notepad++ with table API, and then I have the query. Yeah. In my case, the system has a simple authentication, and I will put my user and my password for the demo instance, and I will get the result. That's all, yeah? So I get this JSON result. Now, I deserialize the result, and then I want to display the, let's first display the, I will disable this, and we'll display on the screen the result, yeah? And then we will we'll put this on a data table to write it on Excel file. But to not complicate it from the beginning, I will just, I hope everyone see on this resolution. We don't need this one. So we will, what we'll do is, we'll just go on the item. So you have deserialized JSON, then here, be careful. You need to get from the JSON, you will get the result. Okay, so you will get the result, and this you have to convert it to array. I have here the command, you can type it very easy. And here we will want to see on the screen the number, the open ID and open at, and the short description. Yeah. So if I run this one, if I run this this command, you will see that I will get from my ServiceNow. So from my system, from my ServiceNow system, I will get the incidents that are having. Look, I have incident 16 and incident 49 with this this time of creation, and the description is step one and step two. So here are my values. Yeah, very easy. Now, if I want to write this on a data table on Excel, because I want to write this on the Excel, I will do this. I will create a data table. So I will drag and drop a data table. I already have this one to gain the time. So I create a data table, and on this data table, I have three columns, number, date, and description. Every column is a string, yeah? You cannot delete column very easy. And here, I will enable also this function that it's writing a row on that data table. So look what I have here. I indicate that it's on the DT, the data table created here. It's DT, called DT. I say write row on the DT, and here I will have item number to string, open to string, and item short description to string. Yeah. So in this way, the system will write all the values on the data table. And now, the last stuff that I have to do is to write this on Excel, yeah? So I will open the test bulk API, test bulk Excel. I will say that I will write on the sheet two, and I will write the data table. And in this way, the data will arrive on an Excel. I will show you the Excel to show that now it's empty. So I don't have any sheet two. I will close the Excel, and we'll see that the data will arrive there. Let me close the Excel from here. I close the Excel. Let's run the robot, and you'll see that the system will extract the data from ServiceNow and put it on Excel. Very simple, yeah? Without any activity and other stuff. Let's go back to our Excel, and let's see if we have the data here. You can see I have the number, the date, and the description, yeah? So very easy, I'm able to extract data from ServiceNow and put it on Excel without any activity. Now, the second step. I want to put this data from the Excel. I will take this data and I will update to ServiceNow, yeah? again, without using any activity. So I have the number of incidents, and I will change the state, and I will change the description. This will be the short description. Yeah? Let's go to my service now. Let's go to all. And let's see this incident. Yeah, you see, I have this incident that is new and has the short description test. This incident new has the unable to access folder, and this incident has the email server down with new. Yeah, so I will show you a code that will update all these incidents. So what we'll do? First, we'll read the Excel. We'll read from the sheet 4. Then we'll do a for each on the row. And now you see here, I have the number of the incident. Yeah. And on the Excel, I have here the number of the incident. To make an update, you need to get first the ID of the incident, the system ID. So I will do a get like this with the number. Yeah. So I will ask the system, please provide me all the details for this number, yeah? Row 0 is the number of the incident. I will deserialize JSON, and on the deserialized JSON, I will extract the system ID, yeah? So I have the system ID. Then with the system ID, I will call the update command. So here I have the update command. The update command, it's with put. The first it was with get, now it's with put. You will see your instance ServiceNow API incident with system ID that I extract. And here I put again the username, the password. Here I have to provide, and I will explain this, I have to provide the body, which is will be a JSON. And I will have to specify that it's a JSON. Yeah. And here I will say that accept format is JSON. So what I will change on my incident, I will change the state and I will change the short description. So in my JSON, I need to provide these two variables. So I will create a JSON object. I create here a GS object, GS object, which is G object, and I will initialize this G object here because for each initialize again for each iteration to be initialized. And then I will use invoke method. Invoke method will say on the target object, I will use the add property. And on that property, I will put the values. So first I will update the state. And then I will say J token row 1. It was the state 257 that you see on the Excel. And here, the second one, it's J description, I will say short description, and I will put the J token as the row 2 from the Excel. Okay. And then I will make the HTTP request. So let's run this and we'll see that the system will read the Excel and will update my incidents with different state. Yeah. Done. Let's go back to ServiceNow. And on the service now, these are the incidents that will follow. And let's refresh. And check my incidents that are changed. Not all. Wait a minute. Pause. It's back. So my incidents are not, this one has not changed, because take a look here on the UiPath Studio. I have print also the response, yeah? And you can see, I'm not able to change this to close or to resolve because it's mandatory to have a close note, yeah? And because I don't have a close note, I'm not able to change to that stuff. So I will go back here and I will say that also the second incident will be in progress and this incident will be on hold, yeah? So if I run it again, so you see, that was a test to show you the that all the comments that you send via REST API are passing the validation rules of the system, yeah? So validation rules of the service now block my decision to modify the state, yeah? Because, so here you can see now I have a full answer for all my stuff, yeah? So I have three results, and let's go back to ServiceNow interface, and we'll see on the ServiceNow interface that this one is on progress, this one is on progress, and this one stayed new. Probably I still doesn't like the state 5. We'll check here. Yes, it's not on hold. Probably you need to put a reason again. So that's the idea with how you can send comments to ServiceNow without using an activity. Yeah. So without using an activity, how to send comments on ServiceNow. And remember, you can, I'm back to higher resolution. And remember, for more comments that you want to send to ServiceNow without an activity, you have these two movies, how to send insert, update, delete, or get, or how to do auto-authentication, download, upload files with ServiceNow without any custom activities. Thank you very much for watching. And remember to subscribe to my channel and ask me what other type of videos you want to see from my YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Have a good one. Stay safe. Bye-bye.